All right, a couple of special guests in studio. Nihan Gorkum is with us. Nihan was born and raised in Turkey. She's a Turkish citizen. She's here working at UTTV and helping us with the social media we were just talking about and doing a great job. We appreciate your being here. We're going to talk about these Turkish riots in Istanbul. Yeah. With her as well is Sarp Sekeroglu.
Pretty good.
How did I do? Sekeroglu? He is the president of the Turkish American Association in Southern California, San Diego chapter. And is also in engineering, has a degree in civil engineering, and has been working in civil engineering on seawater and groundwater desalination. Good, we need that water.
Yes, Sarp, we do.
Glad you're here.
Thank you.
From your standpoint, and you're in touch with a lot of folks who were born and raised in Turkey and happen to be here now, what is the reaction to the awful video we saw just yesterday of a kind of coming back again of all this violence in Istanbul? What's going on?
Well, the police brutality and how the government is handling the protests is getting everybody mad. When I say everybody, these are people that can freely think, analyze, and understand what they're seeing. And when you look at what's going on, kids, young people, elderly, socialists, right wing, left wing, everybody's on the streets. But the police is the only thing they're fighting. They're singing the national anthem, they're holding hands, they're all united. But the government doesn't want the protests, therefore they're charged by the police. That brings everybody here together because everybody wants to be heard and everybody wants the government to realize that they're not alone there. We're all with them.
And we all started because somebody's cutting down trees in a park, right?
Basically.
It's a pretty small thing to ignite all this.
If I could localize that for you. Imagine that someone wants to build a mall at Balboa Park.
Yeah.
Planning Commission says no, you can expect that. But the president says, no, that will happen. We'll have that mall there. Excavators go to the park, people protest, sit in front of the excavator. 10 people or so get charged by the police, tear gas.
Wow.
That didn't make the news. Censorship on the media. That was on Twitter, on videos. That brought
Social media made it possible for people to know what was going
exactly,
on.
Exactly. 100 people came in the next day, they were gassed. 1,000 people came in and camped in the park. They were gassed. That brought in 10,000, 100,000s, total millions.
And the prime minister says, hey, we're not going to put up with it. We're going to send in the tear gas anytime you guys come up. So it looks like there's going to be more.
Well, yes, there will be. Last night, Taksim Square, which is our biggest square in Istanbul,
right.
Tens of thousands of people gassed at once. It was a scene. It was like it was on fire. Nobody could see each other.
We haven't seen that in Turkey. Not in a long time.
Not in a long time. Before 1980s, there was this kind of rioting and all that, but people were fighting against each other.
Yeah.
This time, people are united fighting against the government.
Now, there's been an interpretation I want to run by you, see if it's accurate. In Egypt, the fundamentalist Muslim Brotherhood, fundamentalist Islamic types, were protesting and rioting against the government, dictatorship of Mubarak that was on our side, and kind of more westernized people. In Turkey, it seems like, watching the kids in the street, look like westernized kids fighting against a prime minister who says he's an Islamist. It's like the other way around.
It is the other way around.
Is that accurate?
That is very accurate, because when the current government got in power 10 years ago, they claimed that they're everybody's government.
Yeah.
However, within 10 years, we've seen many laws passed by without any objection because the single government, single ruling party, minimization of personal rights, recently ban on alcohol sales, judgment system is not dependable, nobody trusts the
more
judgment
system. More
towards
Sharia law then.
If that's what it looks like. He doesn't claim that, of course, but it was something that the government forced upon people and it built up. It kept building up these 10 years. And then this last attack on people with brutal police force, and then the censorship of the media, the news stream, the mainstream media didn't broadcast this at all for the first 3 days.
Wow.
CNN International broadcasted it, CNN Turk did not. Yeah. That pissed everybody off even more because the social media, Twitter, Facebook, videos online, and the government, the prime minister gets on TV and lied to the people on mainstream. He said 17 people died in Occupy USA events. Nobody died in Occupy USA.
No. But all right. Now, let me talk to Nihan, because you're a Turkish citizen. You have relatives in Turkey, right? Who's there?
Everybody. Everyone. All my friends and family.
What's their reaction to this? You're probably talking to them.
I'm super worried, first of all. most of the time they don't get back to my calls, they don't get back to my texts. They're like, oh, we were protesting on the streets, so like we didn't, our phones died and like we were hurt. I'm like, are you serious? Like, what's going on right now? And they're like, yes, this is all crazy and every day it keeps getting worse. They send me pictures of their scars and stuff. So I'm super worried. Like sometimes whenever I go to my Facebook, Twitter, emails, I see so many updates. People are trying their best to share what's going on because our media is not covering. So everyone's on social media. So sometimes it's painful to see all of those happening, but I'm also proud of my country and my people because we're standing up, because we don't want our prime minister to keep ruling us in that way. So I'm so proud of my country and my people that we're standing up.
Well, it sounds like, however, both of you describing this, that what you're saying is this is going to continue because the prime minister has said, hey, I'm not going to put up with it.
Yeah.
People have said, I'm not going to put up with it. Wait, you're going to have more clash.
The question mark is what will happen?
What will happen?
What's next?
What do you think?
Well, that's what I asked to my friends and my dad. I don't think he is willing to leave his seat, but he might be forced by the U.S.
This
or by other
army.
Countries. Yes, maybe.
Sarp, what do you think? No, not the army?
Well, there was an ongoing lawsuit since 2004 to minimize army's influence on the politics.
Right.
And when I referred to the judgment system a couple of minutes ago, the case is basically a joke on the judgment system. There is no, the evidence, let me tell you, is Word documents. Not signed, not sold Word documents, right?
Yeah.
So with that, the army's force or influence has been minimized. And the army now is in his control.
Yeah.
So I don't think the army will take over and do this for the people, but the people will do it for themselves. And that's how it has to happen. He's meeting with a group of people that are completely irrelevant, a panel completely irrelevant to what's going on.
And that was the news this morning. There was
yes.
going to be a group of activists that were going to try to meet through mediators.
The mediators, have you seen the analogy on that?
No.
It was like if there was something going on here and President met Kim Kardashian.
Oh, okay. Somebody has no relationship really to the protest.
Exactly.
So what do you think, Sarp, is going to be the next thing to happen here?
Well, the people, as I said, this is people's movement. It doesn't matter what you think, if you're for human rights, and if you want a free life and freedom of speech, freedom of media, freedom of judgment system, that's what those people are standing for. So a panel, representatives from there, are willing to talk to the prime minister. He didn't take it until now. We have a president, too, who's very silent on these issues. So negotiations.
And you've got a parliament.
We got a parliament. Well, members of the parliament are in the park.
Really?
Being guessed.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Well, the opposing party's parliament members are being guessed as we speak.
Yeah.
I think what will have to happen, of course, communication. But the prime minister is not backing down even a single step. The word is, when you're in so much power, you step one step back, you lose it all. That's why he's scared.
We're going to have to pick up this story because it sounds like it's an ongoing one. And I appreciate your coming in. And Nihan and Sarp, thanks so much.